This instructional video is designed to show you how the first wave function for the harmonic oscillator actually satisfies the time-independent Schrödinger equation, which we have written here. If we didn't have any other information, all we would know is that we have a wave function index with quantum number 0 and the energy for that state. However, we have the quantum number V equals 0 wave function for the harmonic oscillator. And because this takes advantage of having a lot of variables kind of bundled together into single constants, have what constant alpha is and what constant omega, the characteristic frequency of our vibrating pair, would be. Now, I also have the Hamiltonian, which you will note is, once again, the kinetic energy and the potential. And in order to step through this, we want to think about the strategy. So essentially, we're going to apply the Hamiltonian operator to this wave function. And because it requires us taking the second derivative, one of the things we want to do is actually just take that second derivative up front, and then we can multiply through and substitute in some things. So the first derivative of wave function V equals 0, the constants will remain. That's our normalization factor. And for the exponential, I need to multiply the exponential itself, which survives, by the derivative of its argument. So this minus alpha x squared over 2 will just become minus alpha x. And we get the exponential back. So that's the first derivative. Now to get the second derivative, I'll need to apply the product rule here. But it's all pretty straightforward. So first, second derivative. So this constant comes out, stays put. And now I want to do the first times the derivative of the second. Well, the derivative of the second term is this entire thing. So a minus alpha x times itself will give me a positive alpha squared x squared times the exponential. And then I need the second times the derivative of the first. Well, this minus alpha x is just going to give me a minus alpha. This e to the minus alpha x squared over 2. And so now that I have the second derivative of the wave function, I know I can plug that back in. But the thing we want to make special care to recognize is that we have the normalization factor from the original wave function, and we can factor out the exponential. So I could rewrite this second derivative in a way that's a bit more convenient, because I can say that the second derivative is going to be all of these alphas and x's. So alpha squared x squared minus alpha times the original wave function. So I've got a polynomial times the wave function. So let's take all of this, plug it into here, and we'll start working. So if I apply the Hamiltonian to the wave function, I will have minus h bar squared over 2 mu. And I'm going to have this polynomial times the original wave function plus 1/2 kx squared times the original wave function. That looks promising because now I can factor out the original wave function and hope that everything cancels to give me the correct value for the energy for V equals 0. So I'll have the negatives will combine, so I have alpha h bar squared over 2 mu minus alpha squared h bar squared over 2 mu times x squared plus kx squared over 2, all of which is multiplying the original wave function. So in order to get this result from the time-independent Schrödinger equation, I simply need to verify that all of this will cancel down to h bar omega over 2, which is the energy for the V equals 0 wave function. And for that, I'm going to need to use my substitutions. So if I substitute in for alpha, I have mu omega over h bar. Then I've got my h bar squared over 2 mu. Here, when I square this, I'll have a mu squared omega squared over h bar squared. And then this kx squared over 2. And all of this. So now, I just need to prove all of this cancels. Well, I can cancel some things. So this factor of mu will cancel with this factor of mu. This h will cancel at power of 2. So this very first term gives me my h bar omega over 2. That's very promising. And now I'm looking at cancellations here. So my h bar squared cancels top and bottom. I can cancel a mu here and power of 2. So this is going to leave me with minus mu omega squared over 2. Gotta remember to pull down the x squared from here. So that's times x squared. That's k over 2 times x squared. So now I just need to do one more substitution. Omega is square root of k over mu. So when I square it, I'm going to get a k up top and a mu on the bottom. These mu's will cancel. So that leaves me with h bar omega over 2. Substituting in the omega squared gives me a k up top and a mu on the bottom. Those mu's will cancel. Work with k over 2 times the x squared, which pulled through. I have plus k over 2 times the x squared. And because these two things cancel, I'm left with h bar omega over 2 times the original wave function. And if you recall from studying your quantum mechanics that the formula for the energy is h bar omega times the quantity v plus 1/2 when v equals 0, that's h bar omega over 2, which is exactly the energy for the E0 when we're talking about the harmonic oscillator. So this is a demonstration of one example, the general principle, h psi equals e psi.